So we're just standing here, and I kid you not, about 6 to 10 feet behind him, swerves a truck right around him with a bunch of kids in it laughing. It was so close to him, my heart skipped a beat, and I seriously thought he was about to get hit. But this is spiritual warfare, I think, going on right now in our life as we walk. Trail. We've encountered this section here, and it looks like there may have been some sort of makeshift bridge at one point, but it's definitely not there anymore. We're not sure what to do.
Either we walk all the way back, try to swim across or something with some stuff, we stay here for the night for Shabbat, and figure it out Sunday.
Shabbat starts in about an hour and 50 minutes. The tide is definitely getting pretty high. So we plan on just having this wonderful campfire tonight and resting the night. Hopefully waking up tomorrow early enough to realize how low that tide is gonna be. So Zach,
yes.
Did we decide to cross the river tomorrow morning?
We did not, actually. We gotta still walk the highway all night.
So you don't think it's safe for me to go run into this water right now and swim across?
Honestly, I don't, man. The tide's looking quite high right now, and the water's looking pretty strong. The current will definitely suck you down.
We are on the other side of the river. Hopefully there's no more surprises. The Trans-Canada people need to be made aware that a bridge is missing a part of their project. Is this the finish line?
That big cart and went to fit around the tree back there, let alone on this path. There's a bit of a cliff down here, right into the water. Plus, actually right here currently, which we're about to pass, the cart definitely would fit here. We could barely get the stroller by. I mean, God really did provide with this these strollers.
So Zach, are we gonna push baby strollers up mountains?
Oh, heck yeah.
In peace, I will lie down and sleep for you alone, or keep me safe. In peace, I will lie right down and sleep for you alone, Lord, keep me safe. In peace I will lie right down and sleep for you alone, Lord, keep me safe. I will lie right down and sleep for you alone, Lord, keep me safe. In peace, I will lie right down and sleep for you alone, Lord, keep me safe. In peace, I will lie right down and sleep for you alone, Lord, keep me safe. In peace, I will lie right down and sleep for you.
Zach's never had straight instant coffee from the package. Bigger back bite. Yeah. So Zach, you think we would have been able to get the cart around that?
Oh yeah, man, we'd plow right through that. No, definitely not.
When you're hiking the Trans-Canada Trail, sometimes you gotta keep a very keen eye out for these things here. They're a little hard to see sometimes.
Right, good morning. So we are definitely not making any distance at all. We're honestly pretty low on food already. Because we weren't expecting all of the issues that we had yesterday to set us back so far. My phone's at 47% and my portable charger is dead. This thing's only going on in an emergency.
So, for this food, this meal, by the side of the highway, got some mashed potatoes, 2 cans of tuna, and inside is a Indian spice curry with rice chips.
Zach, how you feeling right now? Waking up in prison. Looks like a prison cell, but we actually are just sleeping in a car rest area. So we walked about 20 something kilometers all uphill yesterday.
Almost 30, I'd say, actually.
How you feel?
Tired, sore, like I'm up, but my body is aching, my shoulders hurt. And my legs feel like jello.
Do you know that we have to walk 66 more kilometers until we get into town?
Yeah, you don't have to tell me that.
Stop. You can't just chew on everybody's hand.
All right, Zach, we got 64 kilometers until we get into an area where we can purchase food. We're nearly out of food. How many kilometers are we going to walk today?
Nearly anywhere from 40 to 50.
What are you currently giving me?
I'm currently giving you my coat right now.
You're giving me your coat off your back, okay?
Here you go, man.
Thanks. This is the type of guy he is. I wasn't recording. Oh my goodness.
Thank you. All right, your turn. So we're about to make a mixture with 3 cans of tuna, a package of mashed potatoes, some chili powder, and some beans.
So this is how sweaty Justin's back is. Kind of like designed his shirt.
Well, after walking approximately 38 kilometers and having one proper morning meal today, we finally made our way to Merritt, and we are definitely about to dine in at some really disgusting 7-Eleven food. Gonna try finding a spot we won't get kicked out of tonight. There's 100 police cars crawling around the city, so. Well, God works in mysterious ways. We get into town yesterday and we're wondering where we're gonna do, where we're gonna sleep. And so, just as we're about to leave 7-Eleven, some guy comes out and says, hey, you guys need a place to stay the night? And normally I say no when random people ask me that, unless I have a good feeling about them, because sometimes they get a little bit weird and creepy, but this guy was very nice, and so I felt like I needed to say yes, and when I did, he told me about this homeless shelter that was converted to house people for free, and we just showed up, and Cobain's allowed here, and we get our own room with our own beds, and we're allowed to stay as long as we want, so it's a blessing for sure. You okay?
I'm fine. Just a little sore and blistered.